Great Britain is full of fanatics, incredible people who take the word hobby to a terrifying new level. And on tonight's show, we will test our fanatics' knowledge of roller coasters, Liverpool FC, and Game of Thrones, all battling it out to see who will be crowned tonight's champion. Hello and welcome to the Fanatics on Sky One HD. This, my friends, is the show that brings together the biggest super fans in the whole of the UK. Joining us tonight, three fanatics whose knowledge is simply bedazzling. So prepare to be bedazzled. Let's meet them. Up first, he's ready for the ups and downs. It's roller coaster fanatic Colin. He's coming with an army. It's a red army. It's Liverpool Football Club fanatic Paul. And finally, ready to do battle, Game of Thrones fanatic Zara. You're all very welcome, very cocky walks down the stairs. I like it, I like it. We're going to go straight in. We're about to put Colin, Paul and Zara's knowledge of their passions to the ultimate test as they battle it out to be crowned tonight's champion fanatic. Their first challenge is a test of visual recognition done at breakneck speed. Let's play mashup. How are you, Colin?
Hi.
Well, how did you get into roller coasters?
To be honest, I've always been into roller coasters. It's always been with me.
I just want to get on a roller coaster with you for tips. Where's the best place? Is it up front, at the back, hands out? What?
It depends on the actual roller coaster, whether it's better to sit at the front or the back. They're all different. They've all got their own different personalities and characters.
I love it. Right, OK, listen, best of luck.
Thank you.
Colin, you're about to see a mashup of four logos from current UK roller coasters.
OK.
There is a point for each correct answer.
Right.
But you'll only get to see the image for 5 seconds.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I think so.
Okay, here's your mashup.
Okay. The Smiler is in there. Colossus is in there. Ares in there. The other one I'm gonna go for, Rush.
Rush.
There's a couple of them at Thorpe Park and they use a similar logo for a number of coasters in one area. So yeah, I think it's gonna be Rush.
Let's see if you're right, Colin. So for 1 point, we wanna see Smiler. Yeah, well done. Opened in 2013 at Alton Towers. So for 2 points, we wanna see Air. Done again. Is in the Forbidden Valley area of Alton Towers.
Mm-hmm.
For 3 points, we're looking for Colossus. Is Colossus there? Yes. That's Thorpe Park.
I know what it is.
And for the full 4 points, is it Rush?
No.
It's
what
not.
What was it?
It's Dragon's Fury.
It's Dragon's Fury. Let's see if you're right.
Yeah.
It was Dragon's Fury. It's fast. You did really, really well, though. 3 points, Colin. Well done. How are you, Paul?
How are you, Paz?
I'm not too bad. All my mates, right, all of them are Liverpool fans. How did you get into Liverpool?
Well, I was five. I've got a twin brother. You know, you get up on Christmas morning, come downstairs, and my dad holds this shirt up. He says, it's a Liverpool shirt, yeah. Son. And you'll be a Liverpool fan all your life.
And that's it. Right, listen, your mashup is of four former Liverpool players. Now, the club's been around since 1892. It's a lot of players.
Right.
Yeah. Remember, you only get to see the image for 5 seconds. That's okay. Quick. Paul, here's your mashup.
First one was Jamie Carragher.
So Jamie Carragher.
Alan Hansen.
Alan Hansen.
Yeah. I saw Roger Hunt. I think John Aldridge.
John Aldridge.
Because they both wore moustaches, Rush and Aldridge. So Rush had a thick one, Aldridge just had a thin one. My gut says John Aldridge.
John Aldridge. Paul, let's see if you're right. So for 1 point, is Jamie Carragher there? Jamie Carragher, well done. Defender at the club for 17 years, of course. For 2 points, Alan Hansen. Is Alan Hansen there? Yes. With the club, he won 8 league titles, 3 European Cups, 2 FA Cups and 4 League Cups.
It's rushy.
For 3 points, is John Aldridge there? No.
Team Rush.
And is Roger Hunt there?
No.
So who were the last two then? Ian Rush, you were right, no. You did say it. The club's leading goal scorer.
Yeah.
And finally,
Ian Callaghan.
Ian Callaghan.
Oh, yeah.
With 857 appearances. Yeah. You still did very well. Good start. 2 points. Round of applause, please. How are you, Zara?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah. So tell me this. A lot of people are into Game of Thrones. What do you think it is about Game of Thrones?
I just think it has everything. I mean, it's basically fantasy, it's medieval warfare, it's intrigue, you know, there's romance in there. It's basically everything. It just caters to everyone.
All right. So listen, we'll jump straight into your first round. You're about to see 4 actors who appeared in series 1 of Game of Thrones.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Zara, here's your mashup.
Okay.
You look very smug. Yeah. Okay, really, is it? Okay, who did you get straight away, Zara? Who did you see?
Kit Harington.
Kit Harington.
Top left. Jack Leeson, top right. Sean Bean underneath. And I believe to the left of that, Alfie Allen.
Let's see if you're right, Zara.
I hope so.
So, for 1 point, is Kit Harington up there? Yeah, plays the role of Jon Snow. For 2 points, is Jack Gleeson there? Yeah, Jack Gleeson, fellow Irishman. Then Joffrey. For 3 points, is Sean Bean there? Yeah, he was there. Of course, played Ned Stark. For the Game of Thrones slam dunk, is Alfie Allen there? Yes!
Yay!
Alfie Allen plays Theon Greyjoy. Well done, Zara. That was a good round. 4 out of 4. Give her a round of applause. Impressive. So, at the end of our first challenge, the scores are Paul has 2, Colin has 3, and in the lead with 4 points is Zara. For their second challenge, they will only hear a sound and they have to identify it. Colin, you are up first. But before you play, let's see why you're loop-the-loop about roller coasters.
I'm Colin, I'm 40 years old, I live in Manchester, and I'm a postman. And when I'm not delivering letters, I am obsessed with roller coasters. I know loads about roller coasters because I've been studying for more than 30 years since I was very, very small. I've still got my school books from when I was 6 years old. I can barely write, but already I'm drawing pictures of funfairs and roller coasters. Cheers, mate. I love the atmosphere, I love the smells, the design, the queue line, but for a lot of it, it's about that machinery. How powerful is that structure that can carry all those people and give them such fun? I like to have some form of souvenir from everywhere I go. I've collected all sorts, mugs, shot glasses, pens, badges. The most unusual souvenir I've got is a bag of dirt from a construction site of a roller coaster. This is my hallway, which is made up of the parts of the old ghost train from Camelot. I've got George here, we've got the blood fountain. This just came from a garden centre. I'm the UK's number one roller coaster enthusiast.
Yeah! Colin, it looks like you live in a theme park. Is
doesn't
that your
it?
House?
That's the intention. Yeah, it is. That's my flat, yeah.
Tell me what you have there.
Okay, there's a Dodgem car in the living room, there's parts of an old ghost train which make up the hallway, and there's tons of other bits of junk.
Like, there's people who like roller coasters, but that's liking roller coasters.
It's dedication. I like to demonstrate my dedication.
Yes, well done. I'll tell you what we have for you. You're about to hear some station music.
Okay.
Now, do you want to explain to people what station music is?
I think that's the music that they're playing on the station, on the platform of the ride when you're about to get on. So it's.
But you knew that, didn't you? Yeah. Colin, you need to name the ride it was originally composed for, and for another point, the year it closed.
Oh, Okay, interesting.
I love that. That's the first. Ooh, that's hard. Yeah.
It's closed, yeah.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Listen up.
It's the haunted house at Alton Towers. It was re-themed to Duel some point in the 2000. I'm going to have to hazard a guess at this. I'm going to go for 2004.
Okay, so what was the name of the ride?
The Haunted House.
The Haunted House.
At Alton Towers.
And what year did it close?
I'm going to say 2003.
2003?
Yeah.
What, I don't know. Tense, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right, well, let's see if you're right. It was the black hole in 2005.
Yeah.
Sadly, that's 0 points, but give him a round of applause, please. Paul, you're up next, but first, let's find out why you're fanatical about Liverpool FC.
Hello, my name is Paul Tramarco. I'm 56 years of age. I'm a pub manager. And when I'm not doing that, I'm an absolutely fanatical Liverpool Football Club supporter. Yes, come on, you Reds. I've been supporting Liverpool Football Club for over 40 years. I've been to thousands of matches. I've read umpteen books. My holidays, my social life, my work is all around Liverpool Football Club. Managing a pub opposite Anfield's grounds is obviously the second best job in the world.
Thank you.
The best job in the world would be managing Liverpool Football Club.
Oh, yeah!
Every time I wake up, I look out my bedroom window, look to the right, and there's the ground. I have spent well over £100,000 watching Liverpool Football Club, and you know what? It was worth every single penny.
Come on, Stephen!
You don't call me Mr. Liverpool for nothing.
Yes!
I'm going to play the opposition off the park.
So where's the Arkles? Where's your pub?
It's about 100 yards away from Liverpool's ground.
Because I told you a few of my mates are Liverpool fans and they knew the pub.
Yeah, we get loads and loads of people from Ireland, Dublin, you know, from all over Norway.
So is there an invite for me to come and have a pint?
Well, we might let you in. The back up if you don't let United fans in.
I get a few digs in the back of the car park or something.
But you're welcome.
Paul, listen, you're about to hear some match commentary from a Liverpool game. You need to tell me the team they're playing against and for another point, what was the final score? If you're ready, listen up.
Oh, the kick has gone in! It's an own goal! Steven Gerrard, the Liverpool captain, sees it flick in. Remarkably, got their equaliser from a most unlikely source.
I'm wondering whether it's the League Cup final against Chelsea. We scored an own goal.
What are you thinking?
He never scored many own goals, Stephen. And I remember him definitely scoring one against Chelsea in the League Cup final where we lost 3-2. And that was.
Do you want to go with that?
Yeah, I'll go with that.
OK, Paul. Let's see if you're right, mate.
Oh, the kick has gone in! It's an own goal!
I knew it.
I love it! So I think that's probably the first time you've celebrated a Steven Gerrard own goal, is it?
Yes.
Probably. Yeah. You got a full 2 points. Will you give him a round of applause, please? Join us after the break when Zara gets her chance to listen up. See you soon.
Possible. Made possible. Introducing the new Ford Focus with Active Park Assist to help you go further.
You don't get much for £2.50 these days. It doesn't get you through the opening credits of a movie.
But don't worry, PlusNet will give you all the broadband you could ever want from just £2.50 a month for 12 months when you take line rental. Don't miss. Plusnet unlimited broadband from just £2.50 a month. Now that's a blockbuster offer. Call 0800 028 8888 now. Plusnet will do you proud.
Nick Gunn, you're probably the most hated man in America right now. Did you kill your wife?
This is a ticking time bomb.
They're framing me for her murder.
Your heart takes you through some pretty big moments.
Is all we do. First Choice, the home of all inclusive, adult protected.
Find out what it's really like to work as an apprentice today. Search apprenticeships. Get in, go far.
That one doesn't change.
So we're missing some code, I think.
178 and 48.
Where do you think that might be?
Should I put it here or somewhere else?
So you can attach it?
Oh, yeah, you can.
Whoa. Whoa.
It's blinking.
Help your child learn code with the Barclays Digital Eagle. BarclaysCodePlayground.co.uk.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Quiz Night. Every Friday night, four real teams in four real pubs across the country will compete in one quiz.
We spelled UK wrong.
It's a British institution.
Oh, I knew that.
We're getting the answers.
We're a quiz team with a drinking problem.
No, we're a drinking team with a quiz problem.
It's only half the fun.
What I just said.
Yeah. Sorry, I wasn't listening to you.
Are you game? The exclusive new series Quiz Night starts Friday at 10 on Sky One HD.
Welcome to my trailer on the studio lot. Come on in.
I've been cast in an HBO show.
HBO is making a series about Holly G and a neurotic older sitcom actress.
What?
The Comeback.
You're on my foot!
Starts Thursday at 10 on Sky Atlantic HD.
Is it gonna work? Come on, everyone ready.
The new series of Stella starts Friday at 9 on Sky One HD. Or watch it now on demand.
Welcome back to the Fanatics, where the worlds of roller coasters, Liverpool FC, and Game of Thrones have come together, and they all have something in common. They want to become tonight's champion Fanatic. Zara, you're about to listen up, but very quickly, let's find out how much you love the Game of Thrones.
I'm Zara Adesi, I'm 25 years old, I live in London, I work as a selling assistant, and I absolutely love Game of Thrones. I became a fan of Game of Thrones in 2010. From there, I became a bit obsessed. I've now irritated everybody in my life about it. I read Game of Thrones whenever I can get a minute. It took me less than a day to finish the first book. I'm also a little bit obsessed with reading up on various bits of facts online as well. I talk about Game of Thrones a lot. I can't stand Cersei Lannister. She's such a horrible person. Ed Stark, you just want to shake him. It's sad that I'm so emotionally invested in this. I realised how obsessed I've become when I started basing who I became friends with on whether or not they liked Game of Thrones. To quote Cersei Lannister, when you play the Game of Thrones, you win or you die. There is no middle ground.
Just so you know, this is completely different to the Game of Thrones. No one has to die here, right? So how long did it take you to read the first book, did you say?
I think less than a day, yeah.
And how many times would you have read the books? Do you still read them?
Yeah, it's in the double digits at the minute, so...
So, Zara, listen. You're about to hear an actor describing the character he played in Game of Thrones, all right? You'll get 1 point if you can tell me the name of the character, and another point if you can tell me which destination he was heading to at the time of his death.
Okay.
Got that?
Okay.
Sounds really difficult to me, but
that sounds
okay.
Pretty difficult.
Yeah, okay. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Listen up.
First rocked up in an episode called Lord Snow, season one, appearing with Tyrion Lannister, Peter Dinklage. Only make it to episode 3 in season 2. And ever since then, I've hated crossbows.
What is the name of the character and what was the destination he was heading to at the time of his death?
I'm probably completely wrong here. Euron travelling to the Wall, which is part of one of the castles, Castle Black, in the Night's Watch.
Okay.
Or north to Winterfell if it's when he's transporting Arya Stark. But I'm going to say north to the Wall, and that's Euron. But that's a guess. Hmm? That's a guess.
Making this very stressful for me.
I'm sorry.
Let's see if you're right.
My character first rocked up in an episode called Lord Snow.
And it was Yarn and it was Castle Black. You milked it, though, didn't you, for every point?
No, I genuinely, and for a second there, I thought, did they say season and 1 or 3? Because he doesn't reach that far.
And the actor was Francis McGee as well. A full 2 points. Round of applause, please. So, at the end of the second round, the scores are Colin has 3, Paul has 4, and in the lead with 6 is Zara. In this next round, our Fanatics will be blindfolded. And they must identify an object just by feeling it. Colin, as always, we start with you. If you'd please step forward.
Right. That's not a roller coaster.
Colin, under here is something you would come into contact with on a current UK roller coaster ride.
Okay.
For 1 point, you need to name the ride it comes from, and for another point, what is the maximum speed of the ride?
Okay.
I'm glad that's okay. There's a blindfold right there. You slip that on.
Okay.
Yeah, you can't see anything?
Not a thing.
Good. So I'll take away this. There you go.
Okay. Right, so this is soft and spongy, feels like a part of a restraint. Because it's quite thin, in fact, I'm just, that strikes to me as a saddle rather than a seat. Therefore, I think this is going to be one that you
careful where you stick it, Colin.
So, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. So, therefore, this is off a stand-up ride. There's only one stand-up roller coaster in the UK, and that is the Shockwave at Drayton Manor Park. So, if this is off a roller coaster, I believe that is a saddle for the Shockwave at Drayton Manor Park.
And what is its maximum speed?
Its maximum speed is 53 miles an hour.
Is it?
I hope so.
Take off your blindfold, mate. Okay, let's have a look and see if you're right, Colin. You were right. You were very, very, very right. So it was the Shockwave and 53 miles an hour. Full 2 points, Colin. Well done. Off you go, mate. Paul, do you want to step forward? All right?
I'm all right, thanks.
Good man. Paul, you're about to feel a badge from a historic Liverpool home shirt. You need to tell me the league season in which this badge was first introduced, and for another point, who was the captain that season? Sound like something you can do?
I'll have a go.
Well, let's find out soon enough. There's your blindfold. You slip that on. Just throw this up here for a second. And let me just... Right. So what I'm doing is I'm taking the badge off the shirt. So that'll be too easy. I'll put that down there. And you have a feel of this. Don't hear that enough, do you? So the season this badge was first introduced.
Right.
And who was the captain that season, Paul, yeah?
Mm-hmm. It's circular. So that means it's from the 60s. It's definitely a circle. It's definitely a circle, yeah. Yeah, that was the badge that he wore in the 1965 FA Cup final against Leeds. The captain was Ron Yates. So I'm going 64-65 season. And its captain was Ron Yates. Because it's the roundness that's making me. Because they just had the badge. It was just the badge, the live bird. And then it went round. Like that.
Okay, take off the blindfold.
Yeah.
Confident?
Yeah.
Let's see if you're right. 1955, 56, you were wrong. It was Billy Little.
Billy Little.
It's no points there, but well done. Round of applause.
That's all right.
Off you go,
no problem.
Zara, do you want to come join me? Hello. Okay, so, Zara, under here is a piece of jewellery featuring the sigil or crest of a major house from the continent of Westeros. For one point, I want you to tell me which house it represents. And for another point, who is the current head of that family according to the latest published book?
Okay. Got you.
Wow. Because you're about the only one. Throw on your blindfold there.
All right, lovely.
You good, Sarah?
Yeah,
good. Yeah. Okay, so we take this off. Now, you bring your hands over here. Now, what I'll do is I'll just slip this and I'll get rid of that.
It feels sort of almost round, but almost overly around here. Almost.
So it's a family crest.
Mm-hmm.
Many houses have those family crests.
Yeah, so all the houses in Westeros have their own sort of sigil, and they all have their words. It feels quite round inside it.
What would that mean?
Some of the houses with a sort of rounder sigil. The Martells have a sun, the Tyrells have a rose, The Targaryens have a dragon, but it's a three-headed dragon, but it's in a circle.
So what could this be then?
Do you know, I'm trying to differentiate what I'm feeling, but. Oh. Yeah, I don't think it's a lion, which is another one that it could be, which is the Lannisters. I don't think it's a Kraken, which would be the Greyjoys. It doesn't feel like a Moon and Falcon, which would be the Arryns. It just, what is this? I think of the three that it would be either Martell, Tyrell, or Targaryen. But because it's sort of not quite circular, I'm gonna go with the Targaryen house and the head of the house being Daenerys Targaryen.
Okay. Take off your blindfold.
Oh no!
Let's see if you're right.
Ah, well. Where's the Tyrells? Mace Tyrell.
You did so well, though. Give her a round of applause. No points, but so, so close. So, at the end of that round, Paul is on 4, Colin is on 5, and in the lead with 6 is Zara. Very tight. Now, since this is such a unique show, you'd expect there to be a unique prize. Am I right?
Yes.
Yes. But what do you give the fanatic who has everything? I don't know. So we did the only thing we could do. We let them choose their own prizes. Colin, your dream prize is a collection of annual passes to your favourite theme parks. I guess you don't think you've gone enough, no?
Well, I could always go again.
Paul, 2 season tickets for you and your son.
Brilliant.
Well, sounds very nice.
It is very nice.
Yeah, that keep you happy?
I'll keep me more than happy. Certainly keep your son happy. Yeah, he's creepy for him.
He's smiling from here, yeah. You haven't won it yet, relax. And then Zara, the prize is a first edition Game of Thrones book signed by author George R.R. Martin.
Yeah.
What's so special about that?
I mean, when you're paging through a book, I don't know how many times, having sort of that first published edition, hardback, signed by the person who wrote it, I mean, that's pretty special.
Actually, it does sound pretty special now you say it like that. I wouldn't mind it myself. They're the prizes, but only one of them can win tonight and get their dream prize. OK, after the break, things are about to get even tougher for our three Fanatics. See you in a few minutes.
At the Halifax, we think people who give extra should get extra back from their bank. Like £5 each.
You try. You don't get it. We're already dead.
Buy and keep The Maze Runner now, and you'll get it straight to your TV and the DVD set direct to your home. The Maze Runner. Available to buy and keep on early release in Sky Store now.
4 days ago, Oliver challenged the world's greatest assassin to a duel.
He's alive.
If he were, I would have heard from him by now. The demon's head does not take prisoners.
Oliver Queen is dead.
When Arrow is gone, will another hero step up to the plate? Find out in Arrow. Returns Thursday, 12th of February at 8 on Sky 1 HD.
Great shows at 8 on Sky 1. Just over the garden fence lie some of Britain and Ireland's best-kept secrets.
Oh, my goodness.
That is a statement.
As inspiring and intriguing as their green-fingered owners.
You can guarantee if you've got a big one, someone's got something a bit bigger.
This is the one pond you haven't fallen into, isn't it?
Yes, but there is time.
Each week, three gardens are explored and appraised.
We're looking at the lawn.
Oh, will they notice?
Will they notice?
To unearth the best garden in town.
I am green with envy.
Brand new Show Me Your Garden, part of Great Shows at 8. Friday on Sky 1 HD and watch it now on demand.
Yep, yep, yep. Welcome back to the Fanatics, where the battle between roller coasters, Liverpool FC and Game of Thrones is really, really hotting up. So far, Zara is in the lead and Colin and Paul are trailing. But in our next challenge, there's points to be had. Our Fanatics must identify the picture under this jigsaw, but they'll only get to see a small part of it. Colin, come and join me. Excited?
Yes.
Yeah, you're doing good. Right. You're doing good. Colin, behind your jigsaw is a photograph taken from the top of a ride.
Okay.
You need to tell me which UK theme park it is.
Okay.
If you can guess by removing just one piece, you'll get a full 3 points.
Okay.
3 points is a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Take your pick.
We'll go for the middle one, Unlucky 13, please.
Okay. Can we take away 13, please?
Okay. Not too many roller coasters in the UK with orange supports and a black track. I think that is the Mumbo Jumbo ride from Flamingoland, and I think the picture's been taken from the top of the Cliffhanger Tower ride adjacent to it.
So, Mumbo Jumbo Land and Flamingo Ride. That's...
nearly,
never thought I'd hear that in a sentence, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
So, Flamingoland for a full 3 points, is that what you want to go for?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, all right, why not? Let's see if you're right.
Yes.
You are right. That's amazing. How did you do that?
I know that ride particularly well. I really enjoy that one.
I love that. I know that ride really well. Really enjoy that one. A full 3 points. Well done. Off you go.
Thank you.
Brilliant. Paul. Okay, don't you be down in the mouth. Loads of points can be had here, right?
I'm going for it.
Yeah, I know you are. Paul, behind your jigsaw is an image featuring a Liverpool team at Wembley. You need to tell me the year the photo was taken.
Yep.
You clear on all that? If you can do this removing one piece, you'll get a full 3 points.
Okay.
Okay, take your pick, Paul.
I'll take number 8.
Can we take
Stevie G's?
Take number eight, Stevie G's number, yeah. Take away number eight.
Remember that kiss, it was just after his breath.
Paul, if you want, you can take away another piece and play for 2 points, if you think that'll help you.
I think it's 1990. Because we played in the final. That game is at Wembley, and it's got to be a team that's playing in. It was a team that was playing in, obviously playing in red. And we haven't played that many teams at Wembley in red. United, we didn't play them in. We never played an FA Cup final in that colour. So it means it must be a Charity Shield match.
You can take away another piece and play for 2 points.
Take away number 12. All right.
Take away number 12.
Yeah, I'll just.
You sure?
Yeah.
Take away 12, please. Look, I'm big smiles. What's the big smiles about?
It was Charity Shield. It was right. It was in the Charity Shield, and I knew it was against Man United.
So what's the year then?
It was 1991.
At Wembley.
They won the league. It was the last time we won the.
It's like that, isn't it? It's like, why don't I take it away? Put it back.
Yeah, it was the last time we won the league, 1990. 1990, I got the first one.
1990?
Yep.
Let's see if you're right.
I knew it was. I remember that was there. That
was 2 points. Well done.
Cheers, buddy.
Off you go. Well done, mate. Woo. Zara, will you come join me? Zara, behind your jigsaw is a location featured in the Game of Thrones series. I want to know the name of the location.
Okay.
If you can get it, removing just one piece, you'll get a full 3 points.
Okay.
Okay, take your pick.
Number eight.
Number eight. Can we remove number eight, please?
Okay, so... it's a round tower, which would indicate that it's a castle. Winterfell has round towers and turrets, so I'm going to go with Winterfell.
Just like that, yeah?
Hope so. And it's pretty grey, pretty.
Just Paul bleak. Did all the dilly-dallying. And
you know, it's
you're
pretty.
You're just very, very.
Because it doesn't look very sunny. It's not going to be the wall. You know, it's not anywhere where Daenerys is in the east, I don't think. So I'm just going to go straight for it and go with Winterfell.
Okay, let's see if it's northern.
Let's
see if you're right. Looks northern.
Looks northern.
Looks like nothing to me, but yeah, okay. For 3 points, is that the right answer? Yes, it is. Well done, full 3 points, off you go. Yeah. They know their stuff. So, after the round, the scores are looking something like this. Paul has 6, Colin has 8, and Zara's in the lead with 9 points. They still have everything to play for, but only one Fanatic can be champion. Join us after the break to find out who that's going to be.
This kiss is for you.
Coming up at 9 on Sky One HD, Baz is back to try and frighten the life out of his dear mummy. A dangerous game gets out of hand for Brendan Booth in Newborns on Sky Living HD. Revenge rears its ugly head for Frank in brand new Blue Bloods on Sky Atlantic HD. And the new series of Stella is almost upon us. You can see episode 1 first on demand.
welcome back to the Fanatics. It's really, really tense here, and there's so much at stake. Colin's playing for passes to his favourite theme parks, Paul, 2 Liverpool season tickets, and Zara for a first edition signed Game of Thrones book. At the moment, Zara is in the lead, but now everything could change in the space of just 60 seconds. In quickfire, they'll need to answer as many questions as they can. At the end, whoever has the most points overall will be crowned tonight's champion Fanatic. Paul, as you have the lowest score, you'll go first. Paul, there's lots of points to be had here, right?
Right.
This is your chance to seriously catch up.
I'm ready. I'm ready to go forward.
I can only take your first answer.
Yep.
And your 60 seconds starts now. Who became the club's first ever player manager in 1985?
Taglish.
Correct. In which year did Liverpool win the first of their 5 European Cups?
1977.
Correct. Against which team did Robbie Fowler score the fastest
Arsenal.
Ever... Correct. Which Liverpool player was nicknamed Crazy Horse?
Emma News.
Correct. In which year did Phil Neal make the last of his 417 consecutive Liverpool appearances?
Pass.
It's 1983. The cup is named after a battle that took place during which...
World War.
Correct. Who did Liverpool sign for the grand sum of £8,000 on March 1936?
Well, Gordon Hodgson.
Incorrect. It's Matt Busby. Which Liverpool player has received the highest number of red cards since the Premier League began?
Pass.
Steven Gerrard. Which player missed just 6 league matches in the 11-year period at Liverpool before moving to Tottenham in 1981?
Ray Clements.
Correct. By what name was the centenary stand known prior to 1992?
Cameron Road Stand.
Correct. Just in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I watched it getting built.
Paul, you managed to get 7 right, bringing your score to 13. Which means you're currently in the lead. But can you stay there, Paul?
I don't know.
We'll see. Colin, you're currently on 8 points. You need 6 right to go into the lead. Your 60 seconds starts now. Which Pembrokeshire ride has often been voted amongst the world's top...
Megaphobia.
Correct. Which UK theme park has a family roller coaster named after the children's TV programme Ben 10?
Drayton Manor.
Correct. In which year did the big one at Blackpool Pleasure Beach
1994.
Start?
1994.
Correct. The ultimate, Europe's longest steel roller coaster, consists of how many cars?
10.
Correct. The standard French, Italian and Spanish names for roller coaster.
Russian mountains.
Correct. Which roller coaster at the Nürburgring racetrack in Germany reaches a speed of 99?
Ring Racer.
Correct. Which roller coaster is the fastest, steepest and tallest in Wales?
Speed, no limits.
Correct. In which Spanish theme park will you find Shambhala, Europe's tallest roller...
PortAventura.
Correct. Which ride at Thor Park was given the codename Dylan during its construction?
Swarm.
Incorrect, a saw. What is the common term for a hill with a 90 degree ascent and descent?
Pass.
It was top hat. Colin, you managed to get 8 right, bringing your score to 16. That means you're now in the lead. Zara, you need 8 to win. Your 60 seconds starts now. How many different city-states comprise the Free Cities?
7.
Incorrect, it's 9. In the HBO series, they are known as White Walkers. What are they called in the books?
Others.
Correct. The first book opened soon after the murder of which character who had been the Hand of the King?
John Arryn.
Correct. What is the first name of Brienne of Tarth's father?
Pass.
Selwyn. What is the name of the character known as the Onion Knight?
Davos Seaworth said Davos.
Correct. At which castle stronghold does the Red Wedding take place?
The Twins.
Correct. What surname is given to the illegitimate children born in the Iron Islands?
Pike.
Correct. Which people of Westeros were said to have carved their gods' faces into weirwood trees?
The Children of the Forest.
Correct. Who is the King of Westeros at the end of the War of the Usurper?
Joffrey Baratheon. Sorry.
Incorrect. It was Robert Baratheon. What 6-word phrase is usually the last one spoken at the funeral of a member of the Night's Watch?
And now his watch has ended.
Correct. So, Zara, you managed to get 7 right, bringing your score to 16. Which means it's a tie between Zara and Colin, which means the winner is the person who got the final question right in the quickest time. Colin, that was you, which makes you today's champion fanatic. Sorry, Paul and Zara, but you played really, really well, guys. Give them a big round of applause, please. Colin, come join me. Don't look at your face. Yeah. Don't look at your
hair.
Well done.
That was close. That was close.
That was yeah. really, really tight. That was so. That's
Bad luck on Zara, yeah. But.
Yeah, but well done to you. Bad luck, Zara. Well done you. Well done you. So you've won a collection of annual passes to your favourite theme parks, right? That's yours. Are you happy about that?
Delighted. That'll save me quite a lot of money.
Okay, good. As tonight's Fanatic champion, you get to play for one more prize, though. But to win that prize, you have to answer the ultimate roller coaster question.
Okay.
If you get it right, you'll win a behind-the-scenes tour of the Busch Gardens theme park in Virginia.
Wow, I'd really like to go there. No pressure. Okay.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Here's your ultimate question. According to the Guinness World Records, in 2007, Richard Rodriguez broke the record for the world's longest roller coaster marathon for a total of how many hours and how many minutes?
I mean, he can sit on the thing for an hour. Well, every hour he's allowed 5 minutes off and he can accumulate those to get the time off. But he's on there for months at a time. Like, you know, I think we're getting on for 2 months. That he's sitting on the roller coaster going round and round day and night. Yeah, I know. It was a few years ago he started doing it, and some other guys started a day behind him on another roller coaster in Germany. So there was kind of almost going head to head. As for what the actual marathon length is, okay, let's go for 24 hours in a day. Three thousand hours. Yeah, and 30 minutes. Total wild guess.
Oh. It's a wild guess, but let's see if you're right. 405 hours, slightly 40 over, minutes.
Yeah. I will.
But you still did. Man, you did so well. You still take home your annual passes to your favourite theme parks.
Thank you.
And more than anything else, you're tonight's champion fanatic.
Thank you very much.
Well done, Colin. Well done, mate. Well done. Big round of applause, please.
Thank you.
That's it for tonight. I'll see you next time when three more fanatics go head-to-head. Good night.
Pens check, refreshments check, brainy friend who you never usually invite to the pub check. Right then, we're ready for our brand new series, Quiz Nights. It gets underway this Friday at 10. And up next on Sky One HD, 50 ways to kill your mummy.